Greetings, Eric Bakker. Thanks for coming back. The question today is, how can we distinguish from a Herxheimer reaction versus an allergic reaction to herbal medicines? That's a really good question. I'm glad I got a question like this. Every now and then I get one that makes me really have to think about stuff. How would I answer this one? Well, Herx reactions or die-off reactions can be very, very similar to allergic reactions in that they're both immune-mediated. So it can be a tough one to work out the difference. So how I would put it to this person, if they're unsure about the herb, is they would try the herb very slowly first in very, very micro amounts or tiny amounts. Have they had reactions like that similar? So when they took the herb, did they get have they ever experienced that kind of reaction before? You know, with anything they had, with any food they had or any kind of antimicrobial product they've had previously. So that could give you a little bit of an insight, you know, into it. But if you're reacting to any kind of herb, the trick is either A, not take the herb, or B, take a lot less of the herb in very tiny doses and gradually build it up. It's an interesting question, but it's a very difficult one to answer because Herx reactions and allergic reactions can be very similar, as I mentioned. They can, you know, include things like hot or cold sensations, itchy skin, nausea, fatigue, brain fog. The list goes on and on and on. So another thing that you could also do if you really wanted to was do a blood test and have a look at eosinophils and have a look at any inflammation there. You could probably do body temperature testing. You could look at the digestive reactions you're getting to the herbs. Are you getting diarrhea from the herb? You know, there are many sort of subtle ways you could pick the difference, but it's basically a moot point. The thing is, if you are reacting to a herb, you just need to be mindful that you need to back off and either switch to another herb or reduce the dose entirely or space the doses apart. But yeah, I would say be very careful of what you're doing. Too many people overstep the mark when they take herbs, and as a consequence, they get very sick. You know, they'll take a herb for 2 or 3 days and think they're not getting much joy out of it. You know, the dosage isn't right, so they'll take more and then more and then more, and then they get very sick because it builds up in the body. So go very slowly. Very, very slowly with anything that's brand new, especially if you think it's going to be strong, right? Try that. Thanks for the question.